On this day, December 9, 1991, Clementina Suarez, Honduran poet, considered the matriarch of Honduran poetry, dies. On a day like today, Clementina Suarez was found on Saturday, December 7, 1991, beaten and unconscious in her home in the La Olla neighborhood of Tegucigalpa. She was transferred to a care center where she died on December 9 without having regained consciousness. She was 89 years old. The crime was never clarified, so it remains in impunity and is cited as one of the most emblematic cases of homicides committed in Honduras. Clementina Suarez was a nationally and internationally recognized Honduran poet considered the matriarch of Honduran poetry, promoter of the culture and arts of Honduras and Central America. Clementina Suarez was born from the marriage formed by Amelia Zelaya Bustillo, descendant of powerful cattle ranchers from Olanchito, and Luis Suarez, worker. She was the eldest daughter of four sisters, the other being Rosa, Dolores, and Graciela. During her childhood, she was noted for her love of reading, instilled by her father and mother. Among her first readings were the magazines Esfinge and Ariel, founded by the writer Froilán Turcios, also Olanchano, as well as Don Quixote de la Mancha and Latin American writers such as the Ecuadorian anti-clerical essayist Juan Montalvo. Clementina describes herself in her unpublished memoirs as an introverted and precious child. "By then I was writing. I don't know what, but I wrote, in tiny notebooks, what made me remain isolated from others." She reaffirmed this uniqueness in interviews. "I was always self-absorbed, interest in other things. I had more interest in what the elders said than in what my classmates said." Clementina received a liberal education at home. Her father taught her to ride horses, not sideways, as it was customary for women of that time to do, but astride like men. In addition to reading, she practiced oratory and theater at school events and evenings. Clementina Suarez's father was a deputy in the National Congress. During one of his trips to Tegucigalpa to attend the session, he took Clementina, then 12 years old, and her sister Rosa and enrolled them for a year in the school La Instrucción, an educational center for girls where basic elements of mathematics, geography, and history were taught. Clementina Suarez was characterized by challenging social conventions. In her childhood years in the conservative Juticalpa, she was judged for having male friendships. In the conservative Tegucigalpa of the 30s, she gave recitals at the National Theater, sometimes with transparent costumes. Her books were read by young women secretly from the mothers, as they included poems with a loving erotic theme. The author establishes a worldview of an erotic character. The vibrant sensual enjoyment in impulse or realization is always present. Her decision to live life according to her own decisions was also reflected in her out-of-wedlock relationship with the Honduran writer Marco Antonio Rosa, with whom she had two daughters, Alba Rosa and Silvia Rosa. In her biography, Janet Ann Gold cites how Clementina's attitude towards life, a precursor of feminism, has been described by other Latin American authors. "Alone in front of society, she dedicated herself to writing, as if obeying an internal impulse. She dedicated herself to travel, traveled alone, carrying next to the rouch, the notebook and the bunch of verses. One day, when she urgently needed money for a gravity of one of her daughters, she announced a recital in which she would say, among others, her poems, Traje de Astros, dress only with her chest nudity. It was fought by clerics and by men with the psychology of harem." This was A Day in the History of Honduras.